Hello guys, we are back with our next set of video series. In this series, we are going to start the third unit of road safety engineering, guys. So in which we are going to cover the most easiest topics, you can say. Those are nothing but road signs, traffic signals, as well as we'll also discuss about, just give me a second guys, we will also discuss about the symbols, I think, so just give me a second, road markings, okay? Yes, so these are the three major topics, you can say, in this whole unit, guys. Okay, so better before going through this road signs, I'll be just giving you the flow which we will be moving on. Okay, so here we'll, in this whole unit, we will be discussing about the traffic control devices, guys. Okay, so what are traffic control devices, or what is the main goal of traffic control? So to reduce the traffic in a single lane or at some position, reducing the traffic is nothing but the traffic control devices. So these are the three methods which we will be using. That is nothing but road signs, road markings, and traffic signals. So first we'll be discussing about the road signs, guys. Okay, yes. Okay, so let us start. Okay, so road signs. So what are road signs, guys? So road signs are nothing but the signs which we see on road, right? So basically on a road, beside a road, we will be finding some signs like speed limit, like turnings ahead, U-turn available. So like that, we'll be seeing multiple signs, right? So what is the main goal of this signs is a question, right? Yes. So the main goal of the sign is nothing but to indicate the information to the driver. So it might be any danger information or any normal information or any kind of emergency information. So any kind of information, if we are showing it in terms of the side signs, road signs, those are nothing but the road signs. So traffic signs or road signs are signs placed at the side of the road, above the road. So it should be placed side of the road and above the road, okay, to instruct or provide information to the road users. Okay, yes. So this is the introduction to road signs, guys. Okay, so now let us go through some types of road signs, so you will be having a clear idea about this road signs. Okay, yes. Okay, so road signs are broadly classified into three types, guys. So the first type is nothing but mandatory signs. Second type is nothing but cautious signs, like any dangerous signs. And the third type is nothing but information signs. Okay, so in simple words, you can say most of the mandatory signs will be with the circle. Okay, most of the caution signs, sorry for that guys, okay, just give me a second. Okay, so most of the caution signs will be with a triangle, and most of the information signs will be of a square or a rectangle. Okay, yes. Okay, so let us start. So road safety, okay, so mandatory signs. So the first type is mandatory signs. So mandatory signs are nothing but some rules or regulations which everyone should follow. Okay, so it is also called as a regular signs. It informs the road users about certain laws, regulations, and prohibitions. So you should not enter this area. You should have a limited speed limit. So these kind of things are nothing but the mandatory things, guys, which everyone should follow. Okay, yes. So please remember that the only the stop and the giveaway sign are a bit confusing, guys. So stop sign is not commonly a circle. It will be in this way. Okay, like benzene structure. Okay, so stop sign. So sign indicating that the driver must stop right there or just to slow down. Okay, so in both the situations we'll be using it. Similarly, giveaway. So giveaway is nothing but, in simple words, you can say free left or free right. Okay, so the sign is used to give a direction to the traffic, to give away to right side drivers. Okay, so towards any kind. Okay, yes. Similarly, vehicles are prohibited in both the directions. So here, if you notice, the vehicles are prohibited in forward and backward. Okay, so it might be a road upgrade or road construction is going on. Okay, yes. So the sign suggests that the area ahead is blocked from both the sides. The traffic cannot be moved from either sides. Okay, not on the both the sides. Okay, yes. Similarly, no parking. So these signs are really popular for us guys, right? Yes. So it prohibits parking a vehicle in the decided area. So wherever you will be finding this no parking sign, you should not park there. Speed limit. So whatever number is inside it, like 40, 60, 80, 100, 120. So the driver should limit his or her speed accordingly. So what is the speed? You should go below it only. If you go above it, if anyone notices it, they can, sorry, any traffic police notices it, he can book a case on you, right? Yes. So in that way. Okay. or he can stop you and he can ask for some fines and everything. Okay, yes. And the second type, those are nothing but the first type of signs. So those are nothing but mandatory, so everyone should follow. The second one are nothing but the caution. So basically there is a danger, there is something which you should understand, you should identify that it is forward. Okay, so those signs are nothing but caution signs. Okay, so caution signs are used to give a warning to the road users of the coming hazard. So basically whatever danger is coming ahead, you'll be informing them. So why it is caution is nothing but you should know, that's it. You should observe it and you should understand, because or else there could be a disaster happening forward. So that is the reason why you should know. Okay, so sometimes we will be, whenever we are traveling on some small places, that we will be noticing these narrow bridges, guys. So basically the road will be this much of a width previously, but once it reaches the bridge, it will become like this thin, right? Yes, so these are nothing but the narrow bridges. So if someone doesn't know that the road is being narrowed, he'll be going like this only. That could lead to a huge issue, right? Yes, so that is the reason why understanding or observing the caution signs are really important. Okay, so narrow road means in forward there could be a bridge which is a thin. Okay, similarly pedestrian crossing. So whenever the people, there is any kind of zebra crossing or anywhere, so you will be noticing this sign. So basically it is not saying us to stop always. So whenever there are pedestrians, please give them some time to leave. So some kind of chance, you can say. Okay, so pedestrians are the ones to be served first than the rest of the traffic when this is executed. Okay, that means the drivers should either slow down or stop and let the pedestrians move, if any. So if there are any people there, you should give a chance. So that is nothing but the pedestrian crossing. Similarly, cross road, sudden turns and snake turns. So these are the common signs which we see on roads, guys, right? So I'm not saying in your locality, but on highways and national highways and all those things, right? Yes. So snake curve. So whenever the road is in the shape of a snake, so you'll be starting here and you'll be moving like this, right? Yes. So those kind of snake curves, or sudden right or sudden left, these kind of curves will also be shown. Okay, yes. Similarly, information signs. So information signs, from the name only you can say. So basically these signs are used to give some information. So that information could be about the local areas, guys. Okay, so let us go through it. So public telephone. Okay, that's a funny diagram. Okay, it's telephone, guys. Okay, yes. So the sign indicates that one can avail a telephone service ahead. So basically if there is any emergency or anything you want to say to someone for a really less amount of time, like around 5 minutes maximum, you can say. So you can have this public telephone for free, right? Yes. Similarly, eating place. It is a fork, guys. Okay, yes. So eating place. The sign will be usually seen at the highways, indicating any food facility ahead. So basically it will be written 500 meters ahead and like that, right? So basically to show that if you are hungry, you can just go there. There is a hotel there, like that, right? Yes. Similarly, petrol pump. So petrol pump also same situation, 500 meters, 1 kilometer, like that. This also indicates that basically on highways, we can see petrol pumps like continuous, like every 1-2 kilometers you will be finding, or else there will be a huge gap of 10-15 kilometers. So that is the reason why these kind of indications will be given. So basically the driver or the people who are traveling can notice and they can check whether their petrol tank is full, okay, or they can just go and fill it out, right? So in this way, okay, so these are the most mandatory signs, you can say, guys. Okay, yes, so these are the three different signs, and those are nothing but mandatory, caution and information. Okay, yes. So I hope everyone got a small idea about this road signs and their classification or types. So in the next lecture we'll be discussing about the location of signs, so where they are located. Okay, yes. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.